Well, good morning. It's Sunday, February 17th, 2019, and going to get back into working on the brakes on the GL1100. Didn't get anything done last weekend. We went through a pretty good snowstorm here in Seattle, and we got about 9 inches here at our house, but that's a lot for us. It's a pretty hilly area, and it just brings the whole city to its knees. So, unfortunately, we lost a weekend, but that's okay. Not that big a thing. So, a couple of things. Got a bag of bolts and parts and stuff to start mounting stuff on the Goldwing, and a new set of handlebars. I'll show you that. And you actually might see me starting to put some parts back on the bike today. So we'll see what we can get done. I got about 3 or 4 hours to work on it. So we'll find out. So here's the bars I got. TC Brothers tracker bars. They're a little narrower, a lot lower, 5 inches of rise. They should be give me a little bit narrower riding position for going naked. And then a bunch of bolts. Didn't get everything I ordered. Some of it's back ordered, but we'll see what we've got. See where it takes us. So. Okay, so here's the orientation of the internal parts. So first thing that goes in is a spring. Flat end towards the piston. So this is how it would go. This goes in first. And then this guy goes with this. So I'm gonna give it a drop of or two of and try to keep my fingers somewhat clean of the because I don't want to mess up my paint. Okay, I do believe that is in there all the way around. It took one little less pry on it to clip it in there, so I think I should have good brakes out of this. Let's clean all the, make sure all the oil's off this. I'm gonna take it out the house and rinse it off. Okay, here we are with the rest of the parts now. So, start by putting the O-ring in. And again, I'm going to lube this guy up with a touch of brake fluid. So I don't like getting a lot out at this point, just because we don't need to have a lot of paint. So then this this guy on top. And those screws are not long enough. Here we go, putting the rear together. So we're going to start with aligning the components. So again, I think it needs to go just like that. So I'll put that together and get right back with you. Okay, that was a little easier than the front one to do. So I got that guy's put together. So now we'll drop the spring down in there. And we need some dot three on here. Just enough to make this thing slide together. That one's a lot easier to put together because it's not nearly as deep. Okay, this guy will go in. And again, a little more oil. Okay, get all this stuff ready to go. Okay, that's all in there nice and neatly. Okay, this guy. Okay, there's that. And we're going to come in with a lock nut. And then with the clevis, this goes to the pin in just so it won't get lost in this old crappy what's left of the original. And we'll go in there. With the purchase of a select electroless laundry pair, stop by Arnold's today and talk to their friendly. Okay, got all the calipers mounted up. They look nice. Bike is dirty. Been sitting in the garage. Put the fender on. I actually got a Honda emblem put on. It's in good shape. Master cylinder. I need to get some bolts for the rear one. Got some different handlebars. I'm about 80% on these bars. I'm not sure. Probably should have got the chrome ones. But we'll see how it looks. Then I'm missing the bolts to mount the rear master, so I got to go dig up some of those. Fitted in. I got managed to find the engine mount stuff, so we're good there. Got a box out, hadn't looked in a long time. Got new switch gear I bought 10 years ago for it, so that'll make it look nice on the handlebars. And then I got three sets of gauges I need to sit down and go through, and the ignition switch is a bit of a problem. And then got to figure out the mirrors thing. So that's about it for this weekend. It's kind of fun putting some parts back on the old girl instead of working on parts of it.